5 past 10 on the 26th of August. It's a Tuesday.
2003.
Well, basically, we're going up to Stickle Tarn, over the top, back to Borrowdale.
These are what we technically call mountains, and we shall be walking over them. It's a very complicated business. Don't worry too much about the technicalities, we'll explain some of the effects of putting one foot in front of another without the assistance of Grandad.
Indeed. Sir Edmund Hillary, George C. Scott of the Antarctic, that guy Shackleton with the name of the aeroplane after, and then none of them have managed to scale the great heights of Stickle Tarn and beyond. Oh, that guy who crashed in the speedboat on Coniston, what's his name?
It wasn't me.
Campbell.
Nicky Campbell, the DJ. He hasn't done it either.
But the Bennett brothers will.
We will. We will succeed where other budgies have failed. Right, come on.
Cut.
Let's go.
Trace our tracks from what, about 20 odd years ago, when a crew of us came up to Stickle Tarn. They camped there, and the idea was to traverse across, pay the arc at Harrison Stickle, as you can see up there, up to Sergeant Man, where we'll be later, and then across the Cumbrian Way and Stake Pass and over to Angleton towards Scarfell Pipes. Of course, the expedition being led by the famous mountaineer Grandad Bennett and his esteemed partner Graham Shanks, who never failed to get us lost up these places. We ended up 20 miles north in Borrowdale, which is what we'll be hoping to recreate today without the getting lost bit.
years ago. I seem to recall us camping somewhere over on that hillock where Cannon's standing now.
What are you calling a hillock?
We pitched our tents just about there in the pouring rain. Woke up in the morning, literally with clouds floating past us in front of Pay the Ark. It was freezing cold and our father had bought this really cheap muesli, which was 90% sunflower seeds. And most of us chucked our sunflower seeds into the tarn down there and always imagined that we'd return 25 years later to find a field of sunflowers, but obviously the sheep ate them first. So here we are. The lake is said to be a secret entrance over the other side of Paviart into the mines beyond, and this town is said to be guarded by some multi-tentacled serpent.
But it's not even deep.
Shh. Cut.